A very good afternoon to one all. Welcome to this session of orthographic projection of solids part 3. In the last session we have discussed about the projection of cylinder as well as cone. Now let us see, whenever the axis is assumed to be parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Now, whenever the axis, if the case is reversed, that means whenever the axis parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP, let us see how to draw the projections for the given solid, whether it may be prism or whether it may be the pyramid. It doesn't matter. Now, here I have taken a prism. How I am saying it as a prism? Because all the lateral surfaces are rectangles and top portion is a hexagon and base portion is also a hexagon. That means nothing but what? It is a hexagonal prism. It is a hexagonal prism. Suppose let us assume this pad as a horizontal plane and wall as a vertical plane. Wall as a vertical plane, and the line which divides horizontal and vertical plane is nothing but reference line, which will be always represented with letters XY. All these are familiar for you. Okay, now in the last class we have considered the position of prism or cylinder or cone, whatever it may be, like this, resting on HP with its base. Whenever it is assumed to be resting on HP with its base, what about its axis? As we know that axis is nothing but what? I am always keep on repeating the same things which we have discussed in the last class. That means those who are still not following these terms, please try to understand and follow the terms. That's why I am always keep on repeating these terminologies. Now, if it is like this, as we know that it is resting on HP with its base. Now, its axis, what is the position of the axis? It's parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Generally, axis is nothing but what? An imaginary line which connects two centers, top center and the base center. Here, top is a hexagon and base is also a hexagon. If two centers, if you connect the top hexagon center to the base hexagon center with an imaginary line, that will be called axis. Generally, that will be represented with long line followed by a dot. Here, whenever the axis parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP, true shape of the base or top can be seen from the top view. That's why we will start from the top view. That means in top you can notice the hexagon. As you notice the hexagon, you can say that it is a hexagonal prism. If you won't notice the hexagon just from front view, you can notice it as a prism. But what type of prism is unknown. So as to name or identify the particular prism, you have to go through the view from where you can notice the top or base. As if the axis is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP, true shape of the base can be seen from top view. Therefore, you have to start from the top view. Now, if its position is like this, that means in the previous case, the position was like this, the axis center line which connects two centers, top center and the base center. Axis parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Now, if it is like this, here even in this case also, the solid, which is nothing but hexagonal prism, is resting on HP itself, but here it is resting on HP with a rectangular face, not with its base. It is resting on HP with a rectangular face, not with its base. That means it is resting with its lateral surface. Whenever it is resting with its lateral surface, what about its position of axis? Axis will be parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. Axis is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. As we know that axis is nothing but what? An imaginary line which connects two centers, top center and the base center. That means top hexagon center nunchi base hexagon center ki oka imaginary line ni manam draw chesamu ante aa line ne manam em antilustamu axis antilustam. Always axis deni suchistundi height of the given solid. Now, if its position is like this, we know that it is resting on HP itself, but instead of base, it is resting on HP with its lateral surface. Whenever it is resting on HP with its lateral surface, true shape of the base or top, which can be seen from which view? From the front view. That means here, whenever the axis parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP, true shape of the base or top can be seen from which view? From front view. That means generally we have to start from the view from where you can see the true shape. Here the true shape can be identified from the front view, that means on vertical plane. Therefore you have to start from the front view. From front view you can see this hexagon. Only one hexagon can be seen. The backside portion of hexagon cannot be seen. The backside portion of hexagon cannot be seen. Therefore, generally the hexagon, the points which we can see, the points on the hexagon which we can see will be represented with letters A, B, C, D, and which cannot be seen will be represented with letters 1, 2, 3, 4. That means from front view, as it is resting on HP with its lateral surface, here you should not get confused with this lateral surface. Generally, sometimes in the question, instead of lateral surface, it may be asked as a rectangular face. Rectangular face in the sense what? Nothing but lateral surface in case of prism. In case of pyramid, what would be the lateral surface? The lateral surface in case of pyramid will be the triangle. In case of prism will be the rectangle. That means always in the question, it may might not ask it as a lateral surface. Sometimes in the question, it may also be represented as a rectangular face or triangular face. If it is a pyramid, it will be represented as a triangular face or lateral surface. If it is a prism, it will be represented as a rectangular face or lateral surface. And sometimes it may also be represented with lateral edge. Edge in the sense what? Only a line which connects two corners, top corner and the bottom base corner. Here top is a hexagon in case, and base is also a hexagon in case of hexagonal prism. As we know that hexagon will have six sides or six edges. For six edges, six corners will be there. From each corner, a lateral edge is formed. From each corner, a lateral edge is formed. But coming over to this question, first let us take down the question for the case whenever the axis parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. Now, first take down the question. Here the question is given as hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm and axis 60 mm long is resting on HP with a rectangular surface, in brackets take down it as lateral surface, is resting on HP with a rectangular face such that its axis parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Draw the projections. This is what given in the question. You can look on the screen also. Now, according to the question, what is given here? Here, hexagonal prism is given as resting on HP with what? A rectangular face. Rectangular face in the sense what? Lateral surface. This is what the rectangular face is. Such that, what is the position of axis here? The axis is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. That means here, if it's the case is like this, from which view you can notice the hexagon? As this is a hexagonal prism, you have to notice hexagon first. From which view you can notice the hexagon? From front view. From front view you can notice the hexagon in such a way that an edge in contact with reference line. Because as it is resting with rectangular face in the sense, this complete edge comes. The rectangle formed with this complete edge. That's why from front view you can see the hexagon in such a way that an edge in contact with the reference line. The points on the hexagon which you can see will be represented as ABCD, which cannot be represented, which cannot be noticed, will be represented as 1, 2, 3, 4. That means, as this is a front view, we have to represent it as A dash of 1 dash, B dash of 2 dash, C dash of 3 dash, D dash of 4 dash, E dash of 5 dash, and F dash of 6 dash. Whereas from top view, if you project the same points to the top view, that means on horizontal plane, the same hexagonal prism can be seen in the form of a rectangle. That means whenever I tilt, this ABCD points comes below and 1, 2, 3, 4 points comes above. పైన మనకు 1 2 3 4 వస్తాయి, కింద ఏమొస్తుంది మనకు ఏబిసిడి పాయింట్స్ వస్తాయి. మనకి ఇక్కడ టాప్ లో ఏ ఏ పాయింట్స్ కనిపిస్తాయి, ఏ 1 కనిపిస్తుంది, బి 2 కనిపిస్తుంది, సి 3 కనిపిస్తుంది, డి 4 కనిపిస్తుంది. కింద పాయింట్స్ మనకు కనపడవు. కనపడని పాయింట్స్ ని ఎలా రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తాం మనము, ఇన్ బ్రాకెట్స్. నౌ లెట్ us see how to draw the projection for this given question of hexagonal prism. Now, according to the question, I am drawing this. At first, you have to represent the reference line XY, and this will be common for every question. VP comes above XY line and HP comes below the reference line. And here it is given that axis parallel to VP, HP and perpendicular to VP. If the solid's axis is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP, true shape of the top or base can be seen from front view. That means on which plane? Vertical plane. Therefore, I am starting from the front view. As in the question, it is given that it is resting on HP with its rectangular face from front view. You can notice the hexagonal prism is given in the question. You can notice the hexagon such a way that an edge in contact with reference line. Keeping an edge in contact with this reference line, I am constructing the hexagon. As you know that the angle between adjacent edges of hexagon is 120 degrees. You have to draw with angle 120 degrees. Already you are familiar with construction of all these polygons in planes, in projection of planes. That's why you can follow easily. Like this, and while giving numbering, you can see the points ABCD 1 2 3 4. Backside hexagon points cannot be seen, therefore you have to represent those points in brackets. A dash of 1 dash, B dash of 2 dash, C dash of 3 dash. Sorry, my stylus is not working here properly. D dash of 4 dash, E dash of 5 dash, F dash of 6 dash. And after that, you have to locate the center for this hexagon. For any solid, so as to locate the center, you have to choose any two sides. I have chosen the side CD at first, and I have bisected the line CD. And choose another side, any side you can, as your wish. Now, if I choose the side FE, and once again I have bisected the line FE. You know how to bisect the line. Bisection in the sense what? Dividing into two equal parts. These both lines gets intersects at one point. That point will be the center. For any solid or for any polygon, this is the procedure for location of the center. If it is a pentagon, what you have to do is you have to bisect any two sides of the among five sides of the pentagon, so as to locate the center. And this center is represented as
O dash of P dash. And what you have to do is, after locating the center, it is better to erase these things because it seems awkward. Now let us project all the points to the top view. In top view, this prism looks like a rectangle. This prism looks like a rectangle at any one of the points in this. And now at first, what you have to do is, you have to project this axis. You have to project this axis because from top view, you can notice the axis here in this case, because of the separate projector you are getting for this axis. This point will be P. So this should be thick. From here, you have to draw the axis of given length. What is the length of the axis given here? 60 mm. At 60 mm, you have to close this. Just close this, and you have to make every line thick, because this is a prism. For any prism or pyramids, you have to represent all the lateral edges in thick lines. Whereas for cylinder or cone, as there is no lateral edges, just we are assuming some generators, those lines must be thin. Now these points are nothing but, what are these points? 1, 2 can be seen, 6 cannot be seen, therefore it is represented as 2 of 6, 3 of 5, 3 can be seen, 5 cannot be seen. From the top, 4, this is the point 4. Whereas here at this side, you can see point A, B can be seen, and F cannot be seen, therefore represented it as B of F. C can be seen, and E cannot be seen, therefore represented as C of 3, and this is the point D. This is the point D, and the middle point is the O, which is nothing but the axis. And after all, what you have to do is, you have to give the dimension. What is the axis length given here? The axis length is given as 60 mm, therefore you have to give dimension as 60. And here base side is given as 30 mm, therefore you have to give it as, choose any one of the sides and give the dimensioning. Always you should not forget to give the dimensioning. Here once again I repeat you the same. Here, according to the question, hexagonal prism is given. Prism in the sense what? The top and base surfaces will be same. Hexagonal prism in the sense, top will be the hexagon and base will also be the hexagon. The top surface points will be considered as ABCD and the base points will be considered as 1, 2, 3, 4. And its projection is given as, it is resting on HP with a rectangular face. As it is given that resting on HP with a rectangular face, from front view you can see the hexagon in such a way that an edge in contact with the reference line. That means, keeping an edge in contact with the reference line, I have constructed the hexagon. The points which we can see on the hexagon is represented as ABCD. That's why, as this is a front view, I have represented it as A dash, B dash, C dash, like that. And the backside hexagon points cannot be seen, therefore it is represented in brackets as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, etc. From top view, the same hexagonal prism can be seen in the form of a rectangle. That means at one portion, of hexagon, you can see the points A, B, C, D, whereas F and E cannot be seen, which is kept in the brackets, This is E, sorry. Not this is E point, and this is point here. And at the other portion, you can see the points 1, 2, 3, 4, whereas 6 and 5 cannot be seen. Therefore, those points are kept in the brackets, and here in this case axis OP is visible, therefore I have represented the axis OP also at a length of 60 mm, and after all I have given the dimensions according to the given question, base as 30 and axis as 60. Suppose if the question is given for the same hexagonal prism such that it is resting on HP with a lateral edge, that means instead of lateral surface, if it is given as a lateral edge, here also you can see the hexagon from the front view itself, but you can notice the hexagon in such a way that a point in contact with the reference line, that means you can see the hexagon like this. You can see the hexagon like this. That means always if it is given that it is resting on HP with a lateral surface, you can see the hexagon such that an edge in contact with reference line from the front view. If it is given that it is resting on HP with a lateral edge from front view, you can see that a corner in contact with reference line. That means at first you have to draw the hexagon, and after that passing through the corner you have to draw the reference line XY. Here in this case axis cannot be seen. Here in this case axis cannot be seen. Try it yourself. మనకు లాటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ మీద రెస్ట్ అవుతూ విపి హెచ్పికి ప్యారలల్ అండ్ విపికి పర్పెండిక్యులర్గా ఉంది అని క్వశ్చన్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు మనకు ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూలో ఎలా కనిపిస్తుంది, ఆ ప్రిజమ్ యొక్క టాప్ సర్ఫేస్ మనకు కనిపిస్తుంది. ఏ విధంగా లాటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఆర్ రెక్టాంగులర్ ఫేస్తో రెస్ట్ అయిందని ఇచ్చినప్పుడు ఎడ్జ్ ఎక్స్వై లైన్లో కలిసిపోయినట్టుగా కనిపిస్తుంది. అదే లాటరల్ ఎడ్జ్తో రెస్ట్ అయింది అని ఇచ్చాడు అనుకో, యాక్సిస్ ప్యారలల్ టు హెచ్పి అండ్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు విపి, మనకు ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూలో ఎలా కనిపిస్తుంది, ఏ కార్నర్ ఇన్ కాంటాక్ట్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ లైన్. ఇంకా యాజ్ యూజువల్ మనకు కనిపించే పాయింట్స్ అన్నింటిని ఏమనుకుంటాం, ఏబిసిడి కాబట్టి దీన్ని ఏ ఆఫ్ వన్, పిరమిడ్ అయితే ఒక పాయింటే వస్తుంది, టాప్లో ట్రయాంగిల్ వస్తుంది, ఏ డాష్ ఆఫ్ వన్ డాష్, బి డాష్ ఆఫ్ టూ డాష్, సి డాష్ ఆఫ్ త్రీ డాష్, డి డాష్ ఆఫ్ ఫోర్ డాష్, లైక్ దిస్ విల్ రైట్ ఇట్. F dash of 6 dash like this. ఇంకా హియర్ ఆల్సో సెంటర్ లొకేట్ చేసేకి ఏదో ఒక టూ సైడ్స్ని బైసెక్ట్ చేస్తారు. వచ్చిన పాయింట్ ఏంటి, సెంటర్ ఓ డాష్ ఆఫ్ పీ డాష్. బట్ టాప్ వ్యూలో మనకి ఏం కనిపిస్తుంది, మనకి ఇవన్నింటిని ప్రొజెక్ట్ చేస్తే రెక్టాంగిల్ కనిపిస్తుంది. ఇక్కడ ఈ రెక్టాంగిల్లో మనకు పాయింట్స్ ఏవేవి కనిపిస్తాయి, పైన పాయింట్స్ అన్నీ 1 2 3 4, మనకు కనిపించే పాయింట్స్ ఏబిసిడి కాబట్టి కింద కనిపిస్తాయి. A dash of B dash, ఇక్కడ A of B, F of C, మధ్యలో P కూడా కాబట్టి F of O, సారీ O, F of O of P, O of C, ఇదేమవుతుంది E of D. పైన పాయింట్స్ మనకి ఏంటి, 1 2 3 4, 1 కనిపిస్తుంది, సారీ 2 కనిపిస్తుంది, 1 కనపడదు. కాబట్టి 2 of 1 ఐ హావ్ మేడ్ మిస్టేక్. టాప్ వ్యూలో మనకి ఏం కనిపిస్తుంది పాయింట్స్, బిఏ కనిపి బి కనిపిస్తుంది, సి కనిపిస్తుంది, డి కనిపిస్తుంది. కాబట్టి బి ఆఫ్ ఏ, సి ఆఫ్ ఎఫ్ అండ్ డి ఆఫ్ ఈ, ఇటువైపు పాయింట్స్ ఏమేమి కనిపిస్తాయి, 2 కనిపిస్తుంది, 1 కనపడదు, 2 of 1, 3 of P of 6, ఇక్కడ కూడా బ్రాకెట్స్లో కావాలంటే ఇక్కడ కింద పక్క సి ఆఫ్ ఓ రాసే రాయచ్చు, లేదంటే లేదు యాక్సెస్ అనేది సి ఆఫ్ ఓ ఆఫ్ ఎఫ్ అని కూడా రాసుకోవచ్చు. దిస్ విల్ బి 4 of 5, ఈ విధంగా. అండ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ ది డైమెన్షన్. అంటే మనకి ఇక్కడ లాటరల్ జస్ట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ రఫ్ ఫిగర్ ఇఫ్ ఇన్ ది క్వశ్చన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గివన్ దట్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రెస్టింగ్ విత్ ఎ లాటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఆర్ రెక్టాంగులర్ ఫేస్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూ యూ కెన్ నోటీస్ ది హెక్సాగాన్ ఇన్ సచ్ ఎ వే దట్ అన్ ఎడ్జ్ ఇన్ కాంటాక్ట్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ లైన్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గివన్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రెస్టింగ్ ఆన్ హెచ్పి విత్ ఎ లాటరల్ ఎడ్జ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూ యూ కెన్ సీ ది హెక్సాగాన్ సచ్ దట్ ఎ పాయింట్ ఆర్ ఎ కార్నర్ ఇన్ కాంటాక్ట్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ లైన్ ఎడ్జ్తో రెస్ట్ అయింది అన్నప్పుడు ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూలో మనకు సారీ సర్ఫేస్తో రెస్ట్ అయిన ఉందన్నప్పుడు ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూలో ఎలా కనిపిస్తుంది ఎడ్జ్ ఇన్ కాంటాక్ట్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ లైన్ కనిపిస్తుంది టాప్ మనకు లాటరల్ ఎడ్జ్తో రెస్ట్ అయినప్పుడు ఎలా కనిపిస్తుంది ఏ కార్నర్ ఇన్ కాంటాక్ట్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ లైన్ కనిపిస్తుంది ఫ్రంట్ వ్యూలో ఫర్ ఎనీ ప్రిజం ఐ హోప్ దట్ ఎవ్రీవన్ ఈజ్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ డౌట్స్ ప్లీజ్ లెట్ మీ నో through WhatsApp, either through WhatsApp or phone call, I will clarify you. Because 16th is the last working day for you and I will not be available for 2 more days also. That's why I am giving you this video lecture. I am uploading these video lectures for you. Please follow this again and again. These lectures will not be repeated at the class. Thank you.